Why is your aquarium struggling while others look like underwater paradises? Here's the truth. You're probably sabotaging your plants without even realizing it. Hey, aquarium fertilizers sound simple, right? Well, add some to your tank and boom, thriving plants. Wrong. If you're using fertilizers the wrong way, you might as well be throwing money down the drain. But don't worry. Today, I'm breaking down the secret ingredients you need and the exact steps to transform your tank into a lush, vibrant masterpiece. Let's uncover what the experts don't always tell you. Most aquarium keepers fall into one of two traps when it comes to fertilizers. Either they don't use them at all, or relying on fish waste and hoping for the best, or they overdose it. So creating a toxic soup that kills plants, fish, or both. And then there's the confusion. Liquid fertilizers, root tabs, micro, macro, what does any of it mean? Without a clear plan, it's easy to feel overwhelmed and stuck. Let's start by understanding what aquarium plants actually need to grow. It's all about the nutrients. Macronutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And micronutrients like iron, magnesium, and trace elements. These are the building blocks of healthy plant growth. If one of these is missing or unbalanced, your plants suffer. So, which should you use? Well, it depends on the plants. Stem plants and floating plants absorb nutrients through their leaves. So, liquid fertilizers are ideal. Root-feeding plants like Amazon zoards, crypts, and vallisneria thrive on root tabs, which deliver nutrients directly to their roots. So you may need both if your tank has a mix. The most common mistake: randomly adding fertilizers without understanding your tank's needs. Hey, overdosing leads to algae outbreaks, while underdosing stunts plant growth. So start by testing your water and know your nitrate, phosphate, and potassium levels. Then follow the instructions on your chosen fertilizer. But here's a pro tip. Start with half the recommended dose and adjust based on how your plants respond to you. So adding fertilizers alone won't magically fix your tank. You need the right balance of light, CO2 as well. Think of it as a triangle. Nutrients, light, and CO2. If one side is missing or weak, the whole system collapses. Invest in a quality light and consider a CO2 system if you're serious about aquascaping. How do you know if your plants are missing something? Well, yellowing leaves often indicates a lack of nitrogen. Holes in your leaves, that's actually potassium. And pale new growth, it could be iron. So learning to read these signs can save you a ton of frustration, let alone money. So consistency, it is king when it comes to fertilizers. Plants thrive on routine. Set a schedule for dosing, whether it's daily, every other day, or weekly, and stick to it. And remember, water changes are your friend. They reset your tank's nutrient levels and prevent buildup. Now, here's the real secret most people overlook. Not all fertilizers are created equal. Some off-the-shelf brands are watered down or incomplete. So if you want the best results, consider making your own fertilizers. It's easier than you think, and allows you to tailor the nutrients to your tank's specific needs. Plus, it's a way cheaper in the long run. Imagine having the power to create your own perfect formula. It's a game changer. Now, mastering aquarium fertilizers doesn't have to be complicated. Start by understanding what your plants need, choose the right type of fertilizers, and then maintain the balance of light and CO2. Don't forget to test your water, watch for deficiency signs, and then stay consistent. And if you're ready to take your aquascaping to the next level, consider DIY fertilizers. It's the ultimate flex for aquarium enthusiasts. Hey, hit subscribe and let's make your aquarium a masterpiece. Check out this next video and I will see you there.